dynamic, energetic Mr. Vijay Anand.
Stickability improves ability. Wondering what you heard me like? Let me repeat that. Stickability improves ability. You think I'm exaggerating? I'll share two, three cases. By sticking on a particular task, your ability improves by leaps and bounds. Thomas Alva Edison, famous inventor, was a light bulb. Some say 1,000 times you fail. Some say 3,000. Some say 10,000. Safely put, 1,000 times you fail. That's a big number. You and I would throw the towel maybe 7, 8, 15 times. 1,000 times, he still stuck on, improved his ability, invented the right button. The Wright brothers invented the aeroplane. First they used gliders, didn't work. Then their first aircraft had propellers, that went bust. 69 flights, I had an article, it says 69 flights before they could get that steel bird in the air. Stickability improves ability. The co-founders of Facebook were being interviewed, and the interviewer said, overnight, it became a success. The co-founders replied, 6 years, day and night were coding. Do you call that overnight success? Certainly not. They stuck on to the task, and the ability improved. Well, Toastmasters is no different from this formula. We are not insulated, it applies to each one of us. Now friends, I'd like to ask you, how many of you believe that you don't have to stick with the Toastmaster mode? Without coming here regularly, you can improve. Can I have a raise of hands, anyone who believes in that? Very nice. So all of you are out with me, we are on the same page. We've got to stick with the Toastmaster mode to improve our ability. That's one side of the coin. The other side of the coin now. How many of us have had this challenge, these pain points, difficulties in sticking on mode? For whatever reasons, I'll just use my perspective. Maybe I lost interest in Toastmasters. Maybe I found certain meetings boring. People have told me I don't have a mentor. People say I have a mentor, he's become tormentor. People say I don't get a speech slot. Someone says I have a speech slot, I don't have a speech topic. Some people say meetings are boring. Meetings become exciting, people say meetings go beyond 8:30. So many reasons to stick on. Some people say, don't grow up, it's a trap. Some people say, I've already grown up, it's a trap for me now. I don't want to come to Toastmasters. So many reasons not to stick to Toastmasters. Ladies and gentlemen, today I want to share one message with you. Stickability improves ability. For that I've got a 3-point formula, which will help us take the Toastmasters mode very seriously. And I want to use the Toastmasters, Bangalore Toastmasters Club, as an analogy using the word shop. The first point, the famous Chinese adage, it's easy to open a shop, but it's very difficult to keep it open. That's my first point. The second point, a shop is only valuable if it has assets. Point number three, a shop is only healthy if it has transactions. I'm going to use the shop as an analogy to talk about Bangalore Toastmasters Club. Having said that, I'll get into my first point. It's easy to open a shop, but difficult to keep it open. One of the gentlemen from this club, his father started only until the second standard. Rural background, agriculturist. This gentleman who started the club, one of the members, he was stammering. He was scared of the stage. In fact, he would run away from the stage. Those were the difficulties he faced. But he decided to open this shop called Bangalore Toastmasters Club. He just didn't open it, he ensured it was up and running for 17 and a half years, annual meetings. In the end, I'm talking about?
Robinson.
Yeah, the founder president, thank you, Mr. Ram. The founder president of this club, Mr. Robinson D'Souza. Another gentleman today, he speaks so confidently. He's an extrovert, he plays with words, he sets the stage on fire. But 15, 18, 20 years ago, he was an introvert. He would run away from the stage. Today he was wealthy, but 2 decades ago, we can't say the same about him. Tall, dynamic, European looks. Any idea I'm talking about? Claudius. Another gentleman, simple, humble person, joined Toastmasters to improve his communication. He came here, but he decided to keep the shop running. One reason, not only his communication skills, everyone else's wants to grow. Plus, he realized this program teaches us leadership, life skills, not only communication skills. Not only life skills, even leadership skills. And today he's very successful and running his own training consultancy firm. In here I'm talking about
Siraj
Rahman. So these founder members have started it. More importantly, they kept it going. And trust me, they didn't have the luxury you and I have. Back then, I mean today we are EFT. Members come and membership, there we have Venu. Membership says, just transfer the money using EFT. What is that? Electronic fund transfer. These people, they also had EFT. It stood for, except fund transfer, everything else people transfer. Money was hard to come by because who knew Toastmasters? A little skeptical. What does Toastmasters have to offer? Very difficult. Today we have the internet. People see the website, they come to our club. Those days, no internet. Without internet, they got people in the net. Of Toastmasters. See how hard they work. So we got to doff a hat off for them. The least we could do, the effort they are putting in starting this club, friends, we have to keep it going. So my first point is, remember, opening a shop is easy, but we got to keep it, we got to ensure the shop is open. That brings me to my second point. How do we ensure the shop is open? My second point was, ensure the shop has a lot of assets. And the analogy here, assets are wonderful, Toastmasters, the members. Without members, what good is the club? I've just had a few members who are truly, every member is an asset organization, but in the interest of time, I'll just take 3-4 names. This gentleman, when he joined Toastmasters, he said, I don't have fear of the stage, public speaking. I'm wondering who this soul is. All of us come here, we say fear of the stage, public speaking, mind going blank, nervous, knees knocking, shivering, all that stuff. This man said no. But Toastmasters didn't leave him. He said, you're good at that? Great. Then come and improve here. That's the beauty. And all these founder members, those who were weak, they motivate them to join. Those who are very good, this is the Toastmasters asset. He's already good public speaking. Such was so good with his skills, he went on to mentor people. This Toastmaster has about, hold your breath, 500 children who have been mentored by him. Outside of the club. And even at the club, he's a mentor par excellence. Great evaluator, great motivator. Anyone, any idea I'm talking about?
Rajdeep, sir.
John Bosco Abraham. Rajdeep doesn't have 500 children. They have one child. Ryan, what a verb on your part. Huh? Club. She was an asset even outside of Toastmasters. In 2002, the person sat in front of you, wanted to join Toastmasters. He read an article in Times of India. It says, Bangalore Toastmasters conducting a speech craft. And lo and behold, I came in 2002. This Toastmaster conducted a workshop on safety awareness while using on Bangalore's roads. She conducted a speech craft for dyslexic children. She's the first lady president of the club. The first lady DTM of this club. No prizes for guessing I'm talking about. Mr. Manmohan. Another asset of our club. Another gentleman, he just plays with words. I say he's a talking encyclopedia. You just have to press a button and he'll give you a sentence, any word you ask for. People hear him speak once, they are mesmerized. Just once is enough. And they say, I want to be like that man. They hear him speak, they say, I want to join Bangalore Toastmasters. In fact, the VP membership over the years have had a big challenge because of the gentlemen. They hear the gentlemen speak and they say only one club. There are about how many clubs in Bangalore? Community clubs, Dutch? 14, 15. Kavya, how many corporate clubs? 20, 25, okay. But 35 clubs in Bangalore, they want to come here. Corporate clubs, people from their club, their organization, they come here. Courtesy is gentlemen. Any I'm talking about? Dr. Razi Manmani. Another gentleman we have, slim, handsome, and he's blessed with gift of the gab. A great voice that he's got. I don't have an English word. When he speaks, people are just awe-inspired. they want to speak like the gentleman. He wonders how he's become so confident he can strike up a conversation with anyone. He takes part in a competition outside the club. He's invaluable to the club. Any I'm talking about?
Anmol.
Like his name was invaluable. Yes. Well, the paucity of time, I'm just stop mentioning more examples. Having said that, every member is an asset to the organization. Every member. A new member, someone who's been there for 2 years, someone for 8 years, 10 years. But the point is, we have outstanding assets. Outstanding assets we have. Those outstanding assets have to come into the club. Then the club will be very strong. It's my humble appeal to you. Please, don't be regularly irregular like me. Please come to the club more often. Then the club will be very strong. So I finished 2 points in my formula. The first one was opening a shop is here, but keeping it open is very important. The second one, a shop is only as valuable as its assets are. Having said that, it brings me to my third point in my formula, which is yes, you've got to utilize those assets. Transactions, in this case, the members. What good is anyone's potential if it's not tapped, it's not utilized? A few examples here. This gentleman, he came to the club, I think 1.5 years ago, maybe 2. And he said, he claims, he was not a very good speaker. He claims, he was scared of the stage. He claims, he doesn't have leadership qualities. He claims, he can't shoulder responsibility. And this man, for 4 months, has been leading the club in an excellent manner. Yes, I'm talking about our president. All I can say is, when God is in the fray, lesser mortals like me, we need transactions. Yes, he's not just transactional, he's a transformational leader. Another member, generally people join here because it's very passive. Very scared. I was one bloke who was very passive, shy, hesitant, low on confidence. That is the rule. But the exception, one gentleman joined here because he was aggressive. He got this feedback from his boss, his colleagues, that he was aggressive, he has to tone down and become assertive. Have you heard that? That is the exception to the rule. This gentleman will be aggressive, and if you see his physique, his build, you will agree, no, he has, he sent out signals that I'm aggressive. But today, he has toned down. Not the physique, I mean, the behavior pattern, assertiveness. Now with a smile, and with a lot of verve, he gets the job done. 4 months, excellent meetings at PTMC. Not one speaker has backed out. Electrifying, energetic, enthusiastic meetings. No prizes for guessing, I'm talking about. Yes, the vice president of our club. That's it. In action of the assets. Another gentleman, he runs, not from the club. He doesn't make us run. He runs, he's a fitness freak. He comes here, he runs, his pen, jotting down every word that's being said at the meeting. Such an enthusiast for this particular movement, he claims, I could not face people. I could not accept feedback. And as a committee member, which in itself is daunting, very daring, very demanding. As a committee member, he's completed his CC, 10. Any idea I'm talking about? I don't want to throw light on this name, because the name is Prakash. Prakash, keep it going, transactions. Thank you. Very kind of you. Others, Prakash, ripple pat. Only for me. PPE clap. Secretary takes the back seat. Absolutely not. I wanted to clap a little slow. Thank you, Trish. Yes. Another member who's in the pharmaceutical industry, in the sales, he's in the pink of health, being in the critical industry. He even ensures BTMC's bank balance is in the pink of health. And not only that, his Toastmasters journey is in the pink of health. Another committee member, taking care of finances, club's finances, his finances, and also CC10. 10 projects. Any idea? Ratan Shetty. One more example. Another classical example. I joined 2002, 15th November. 29th November, 3rd Friday, when I came to the Toastmasters meeting, I was voted in. That's a practice at this club. This gentleman, because he came a week earlier, that was a swearing in. the day I was voted in, he was voted as a member. And along with him on the stage was this pretty charming young lady, Priyanka. Both of them were sworn in the same day. 2002, he began his journey. 2004, 2 years, he completed 4 projects. He left Toastmasters. He lost interest, he claims, in Toastmasters. But the coincidence was even Priyanka left the same time. No, but I take it his reason, what he said to me in the mail, that because I lost interest. 2004, sabbatical. 2008, comes back to Toastmasters with a big bang. Came back, attended one meeting. Unfortunately, had was transferred to Pune, work pressure. Second time, unlucky. 2013, comes back for the third time lucky, class of literature in English. 2013, no looking back. He's come back here, he's on his journey to complete CC10. He works with Honeywell. And he tells his honey, everything's well now, Toastmasters. He wants to become, from being the software field, he wants to be a public speaker. And Toastmasters help him discover that. That is for you, transaction in action. Yes, friend, my third point. There's no point coming to the club like a blue spectator, folding your hands, listening to great speeches. Wow, that was a good speech. Fantastic impromptu, out of the world evaluation. That's nice. One thing, only one thing happened. You'll warm the benches, that's all. You gotta come onto the stage and start speaking. One bloke who made use of all of this. 2002 he joined, he was a bachelor. Very shy, low on confidence. 2003, he gets married. He couldn't speak to a girl, make eye contact with the girl. He finished 4 projects from 2002 to 2003. 4th project, Kishore, how to say it, right? I finished that project, how to say it. 1 week later, I proposed marriage. That's Toastmasters. Professional life, personal life, social life, it helps you, providing you are at the moment. So remember, friends, we might lose interest, whatever reasons. But remember, there's only one way you can improve. Stickability improves ability. From that, my humble request to you, don't wait for some good day, auspicious day, June 30th, half yearly closing accounts, Jan 1st resolution, Deepavali, Ganesha, all that's fine, I respect all of that. Right from today, the 2nd of May 2014, take that pledge that I am going to be your Toastmasters. There is no shortcut. If you're with the movement, you're bound to learn, grow and improve. If you rest, you're going to rust. So as I sign off, I just leave you with one message. Remember, let this be foremost on your mind. Stickability improves ability. Mr. MC.